Welcome to my episode of Simple Game Mechanics in Drag and Drop in Game Maker Studio 2. This time I will show you how to make a countdown clock, which you can implement immediately into your game. Countdowns have many functions, by setting time limits or making triggers possible. Just when understanding countdowns, it can help you a lot to make your game more interesting and interactive. Game Maker is an object-oriented game engine. We will first create an empty object and give it the following functions. We give it a starting value. We change that value over time, and we call and print this value on the screen. To start creating an object, just go to the folder object, right mouse button, create object, or use the alt combination, alt-O to create a new object. This will be the empty object, so we will not give it a sprite, I will just give it the name controller, and I'm going to add the event. First, we create a create event to set the time variable. So we will drag in the variable and we assign a new variable. I give it a kind of a long name because time is already existing in the game maker, and I will give it a value of 30 because I'm going to count from 30 seconds. The second thing that I'm going to do is assign an alarm countdown. At this moment it's half a second. I know this is half a second because when I'm going to main, I can check the frames per second. So the alarm is going to use the frame per second. So if we want to have a second, we need to use the same value as the room, which is 60. So the countdown should be 60. As we create an alarm, we also need to add the event of the alarm. So the alarm will be called in 60 seconds, and then we have the event call from the alarm. And in that case, we are going to call back the variable of times. So I call it times frame. Game Maker will remember that it's times frame, and I will say value minus 1, and I will check in relative, which means it will change the value that is already assigned. Now we have just that it counts only one time, so we want to continue counting. So I'm going to just drag in the alarm countdown 60, so it's going to call itself again to do it again. At this moment we already have a countdown that just keeps counting down from 30. We haven't told the game engine to stop when it is on 0, so we're going to do that now. And we do that with the event step event. Step event means that every step of the frames is going to check if that variable is changing. So we set the times frame. And we say if it's equal to 0, in that case, I want to restart the room. Now we basically have an invisible trigger event, which we can't see yet. To make it visible, we need to add the event draw UI and drag and draw event to draw the value changing on the screen. So call the times frame value, and the caption I will just going to say time left. This is just like the text that you will see on the screen, and I will change the x value to 50 and the I value also to 50. Now we have everything finished, so we are going to click on the room, open the first room, and drag in the object controller. Press S5 or click on the arrow next to the scarab, or of course the bug, as that is the debug mode. Anyhow, now you can see your countdown in work. Well done, now you learned how to create one of the most useful game mechanics out there. Next week I will explain how to spawn objects, so don't forget to subscribe to miss none. Or continue with one of the bigger tutorials I already made to make something bigger from scratch. Thanks for watching, and see you around.